all you demons, and happy Friday. I hope you all enjoyed your week. In honor of Native American Heritage Month, we're going to be looking at some indigenous folklore. So if fish women and undead liver-stealing skeletons tickle your fancy, stick around to the end. The Nua tribe in Scala, Mexico, talks about witch vampires that can transform into several animals at will, favoring the turkey. Animals that these witch vampires decide to turn into end up having a radiating glow around them. These creatures are known for actually feeding off of the blood of children and babies. However, unlike the normal vampire, women are usually born these creatures and don't find out till about puberty. It can cause a lot of stress in a family if they find out one of the other family members is a Tlahuelpuchi, and they'll go through great lengths to try to cover it up. Lucky for them, a Tlahuelpuchi can't actually attack a family member that hasn't revealed its secret, so awesome. Cases of children passing to Tlahuelpuchi actually became so abundant that in 1954, Tescala, Mexico mandated that family members who had children that passed to Tlahuelpuchi were mandated to report it to the medical professionals in their area. Adding on to the strangeness, the last known execution of a woman who was thought to be a Tlahuelpuchi was in 1973. Hopefully when you're hunting for your turkey, you don't accidentally kill one of these creepy things instead of, like, you know, a normal turkey. The deer woman is described as being a beautiful spirit that can either transform into a woman or a deer at will. It's said that she represents fertility and love. In some cases, she's said to join nighttime celebrations dancing with people, and then once the music ends, she leaves. However, in other depictions, she is said to lead desperate men out into the woods to either trample them or leave them lost there in the woods. However, there is a way to survive this. If you look at her cloven hooves, or notice them, it's able to break you out of a trance, and then you can realize that she's a deer woman and then run away. Can you imagine just like having that one chance with a girl and then boom, she's a deer woman who leaves you in the woods? Oh, that's like the worst love story. This creature is depicted as being a malevolent cannibalistic creature with insatiable hunger. Legend says that the spirit of the Wendigo possesses those who are unlucky enough to have to resort to cannibalism for survival. Others say it's a creature that just stalks the forest looking for human prey. What I find very interesting is its connection to the medical term Wendigo psychosis, which is the fear of becoming a cannibal, but also the need to eat human flesh. Wendigo psychosis is said to occur most commonly in those who live in the Great Lakes regions of Canada and the US. This shockingly coincides with the location of reported Wendigo cases. Okay, note to self, not living in Great Lakes regions. At number 2, we have the Bighawk. The angry spirits of these warriors are said to have glowing red eye sockets, emaciated skin, and tattered clothes that they were killed in. These warriors, however, are unable to rest because they weren't buried properly or died dishonorably. Legends say that these creatures hunt for warriors using their club or invisible arrows. They're said to fly through the night, screeching and be invisible as well. Once a creature is able to successfully knock a warrior unconscious, he gets their liver and eats it and replaces it with a stone. When the warrior wakes back up, he'll eventually go back to his village and rapidly start to die because his liver is a rock. I don't see how you would survive. However, there is an escape from these. If you're able to give it a proper burial, its soul can finally be at peace and move on to the land of souls. The Inuit people describe the Kalupalik as fish-like women with green skin, long hair, sunken eyes, and long claw-like nails on their webbed hands. They dwell under the frigid waters of the Arctic and entice unruly children away from their homes or families. They do this by humming or tapping on the ice underneath the child, eventually going further and further away from the families. Eventually, when it's far enough, it'll jump out of the water, grab the child, or just break through the ice and drag the child down into its lair. There, it puts the child to sleep and feeds off of the child's youth. This is how they're said to live forever. However, in some terrifying stories, they're said to be able to walk on land, and this is how it catches children who are lost in blizzards or snowstorms. Like, could you imagine just walking along and then you look underneath you and you just see, like, a fish creature knocking on the thin ice below you? Like, no! Thank you all so much for watching. If you like this video, then I know you'll like this video. Or this video. Please, don't forget to follow me on Instagram or my TikTok. The links will be in the description down below. Thank you all again so much for watching, and as always, stay spooky. Bye-bye.